In the realm of the spirit, I have been carried on the wings of an angel and we entered into a cloud. When we entered into the cloud, the angel told me that he's going to show me something. When we enter into the cloud, I saw the same thing, this church setting. I saw like this event was taking place. And I saw an angel of God with a very huge light. And the light was shining towards the people of God. Hallelujah. And God said to me that after tonight, the people of God have seen a green light.
Amen.
Come on, I wish you can do a bigger amen than that. God said that after tonight, the people of God have seen a green light. Woman of God, I've never seen you before, but the Lord said that he have his hands upon your life.
Amen.
And I see an anointing over your life.
Amen.
I don't know what your name is, but God said that you shall be called pastor.
Amen.
Pastor.
Amen.
Pastor.
Amen.
Woman of God, what do you do? Please come forward. What do you do? A vocational training center. What church do you go to? You was the first lady of a church. It's okay. It's okay. The Lord said that you will be called pastor, which you already are. But I see an anointing over your life. And God said to me that after this evening, doors are getting ready to open for you again.
Amen.
Oh, come on. If you are clapping, do it better. Do it better.
Yes.
Do it better. Do it better.
Yes.
Somebody shout fire.
Fire.
Shout fire.
Fire.
Shout fire.
Fire.
Oh, God. Tonight, can we take an additional 30 minutes? Just 30 minutes and then we will go home. We usually close at 12. But can we take an additional 30 minutes before we go home? Woman of God, the Lord is telling me to do something for you tonight. I'm giving you within the space of 2 months. 2 months. 2 months. The Lord said that he will visit your house again. And the Lord said that the years that the caterpillars, the cankerworms have eaten, he, God, shall restore. I even see a door in like the Caribbean somewhere being open for you. Like a door in the Caribbean somewhere being open for you. The Lord is saying that before the year come to a close, you will begin to minister in the power and in the glory of God again. And it will be even more than the first. Somebody give God glory. Oh, somebody give God glory. Somebody give God glory. Give God glory. Mama, can I pray for you? Mama, in the realm of the spirit, I'm seeing a man with a sword. And I'm seeing that the man is... Mama, for the past, I don't know, but have you had a dream? And in the dream, it was like somebody was chasing you. You had a dream like that. When was that? You can't remember. But you've had, thank you, but you've had a dream like that. I see a man with a sword, and the man is chasing you with a sword. But I see on the sword, I see a name that is written on the sword. I see a name like, it's hard to pronounce, but I see something like, Agbuzin, A-G-B-E-N, something like that. A-G-B-E-N Agbonsu. I don't know how to pronounce the G in there. But I see that name on the sword. And I see that sword lifted up against you. But the spirit of the Lord said that whoever have lifted up a sword against you, tonight that person shall die by fire. Somebody shall fire.
Fire.
Shall fire.
Fire.
You may have a seat.
Gates of hell.
Let Mama, please, let me pray for you.
Let it rain. Open the floodgates.
Open the floodgates. Mama, does that name I said make sense to you? Who? What is that name? That does it make sense to you? Huh? I don't know, something like that. But the pronunciation is hard because of the G. But it's A G. I'm not hearing it. I'm seeing it. Abonyo, that's the name. Abonyo. What is that? Ewe name. But does it make sense to you? Do you know anybody by that name? You know anybody who? Your brother-in-law. Mama, lift up your hands. I release a prayer for you tonight. That anybody that have lifted up a sword against you and your family, tonight may that sword turn back to them. In the name of Jesus, let that sword return back to them. Who's Nash? Nash, come. Nash. Because I'm seeing a banner that was behind you, and I'm seeing the name Nash, N-A-S-H, written on the banner. Nash, we are coming. Stretch forth your hands. So Lord Jesus, tonight, speak. Nash, does that name make sense to you? Nash, it doesn't make sense to you. What is your mother's name? Casey. Check and find out if anybody in your mother's side is coming from your mother's side. Goes by the name Nash. Check and find out and let me know. But I'll pray for you for something else. Keep standing here for me. Stretch forth in your hands on our mother here. Clap your hands and pray that anybody chasing her with a sword, let that sword turn back to whoever it is. Clap your hands and begin to pray. Papatos abrantayas. Mama, in the realm of the spirit, I see your husband being killed over a land. It's like a property. I see your husband in the realm of the spirit being killed over a property. There is a property that somebody have also set their eyes on. And I'm seeing that that person have taken him to a place that they have said to the juju man that if he will not leave that property, then he should die. I'm seeing that they have given your husband up to the close of this year. But I see an angel of the Lord that when he went into the place, the juju man told the person that there is a prayer that is backing this man. And before this man can die, they have to first take you because your prayers is backing him. So I'm seeing that the person even laid an offering with the juju man and said that then if that's the case, then they should take you. So it will happen in a way as that they will take you first, only with the intention of taking your husband after, because you are the prayer woman that is standing behind your husband. But God said to me tonight that there is a covenant that, oh God, thank you Lord, there is a covenant that he have with you and your children, and until that covenant is fulfilled, nobody and nothing shall kill you. For God said that he shall bring forth that promise that he had promised you.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
Oh Lord God.
Thank you, Holy Ghost.
I'm seeing a young man that even is holding a microphone and with a clerical. Mama, maybe you don't remember, there was a time back in Ghana, you took care of some, it was a pastor, but a young pastor. You took care of some, a young pastor before, some time in Ghana, you took him as your son. And you really, really catered and sheltered him. God said, for me to tell you, that because of that, God said that he had visited one of your male child. And the Lord said to me that one of your male children will glorify you in this year. Because I'm seeing that. Mama, maybe you don't know. Let me tell you this. Oh, Lord, I feel it tonight. One of your children is doing a, is orchestrating a surprise for you. One of your children is orchestrating a surprise. I don't know what it is, but God said that one of them is doing something that is a surprise. You don't know of it, but it will surprise you. And when you see it, you will cry tears of joy. Mama, lift up your hands. Receive what the Lord has for you in this season. In the mighty name of Jesus, let it be so now. And anybody that have lifted up a sword, let that sword return back to them. In the name of Jesus, may whatever your hands touch, let it be blessed. May God continue to make you the prayer giant of your family. When you break, let it be broken. When you lose, let it be loose. In the name of Jesus, nothing at all shall cripple you. Nothing at all shall take you out. You are strengthened in the house of the Lord today. In Jesus' name, amen. Put your hands together for Jesus and shout fire. Shout fire. Shout fire. Shout fire. Shout fire. I pray for you. I cancel any hospital visitation in the name of Jesus. You will not visit the hospital in Jesus' name. You will grow to old age and you will glorify the name of the Lord in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Come. Do your hands like this. Clap your hands three times. Clap your hands three times. Clap your hands three times. Do it again. One more time. I see that a name have dropped in your hands.